Welcome back, everyone. We're into the second series of the day, so this is not winners or losers, it's just the fresh best of three for the second pair people.
Yeah, and for those who don't know Hate Me, that are like myself and Zombie, I'm not well acquainted with the player. He is Zerg, as it turns out.
Yeah, it's not familiar. As I said, we've cast him once or twice before, but more in the lines of, like, we were looking to the other person to follow the person's bracket, or... You know, he was the only one that didn't have a game or something like that. I know he's decent, but as I already said about Strange, Strange has been on the, like, up and up, kind of, like, silently but surely. And he's looking, like, you know, he's beating out the contenders for those top spots, which could happen in this group, too. Who did we just cast?
Laser and Beastie Cutie.
Thank you. Which I think is a Laser would be the first one. Now he's already won one. It's Frozen Temple, it's a fresh best of three, it's a PVZ in the bottom right, as the Red Zerg, he is Hate Me.
And his opponent in the upper left side, it's going to be the Blue Protoss, Strange. Now, Strange has actually been on the stream a couple of times, we've seen him in Corsair Cups, and usually the smaller events. Seeing him here is pretty good. I actually would imagine, because I don't remember seeing him in the qualifier, was he one of the guys who made it through the ladder invites?
Probably.
Okay. Because for him, obviously, if you've seen him a couple times, he can be quite, say, skilled with the depths. That's a phrase to say.
Skill. Clearly, skill. I don't remember seeing Hate Me either, to be honest, in the qualifier, so...
I'm pretty sure we've actually cast Hate Me before, but unfortunately, I just don't remember much about him.
We definitely have.
I think it's safe to say at this point we've cast pretty much everybody at some point, like once.
Yeah, it was Strange for this group getting to the ladder, and BCQD replaced Marine Lord, and that's why he's in this group too. There you go. The more we know, knowledge is power.
Oh man, people who replace other players end up doing pretty good a lot of the time.
Only if they use you thermal. Seen.
Okay, well, as far as the openings go, no one's doing anything too crazy. No proxies. I mean, maybe he'll block this out to be annoying, but I mean, there's nothing really insane starting this off. So that's good on both sides, because I think for me, I really do want to see a macro game between the two. I don't want to see this big adept all in that just ends the game at the 5-minute mark, but we'll see if Strange decides to go that direction or not.
Well, he might. It's kind of like a test that you brought up earlier in the cast with Cass, I think. And the 2-Rex? 3-Rex? Whatever it was. Anyway, you throw out something a little bit cheesy, a little bit aggressive, see how they react to it, and if they have a very good defense, like you know them a little bit better as a player, maybe you all throw it all in and you just waste a game. Maybe you only went for a little bit more aggression and you go into a macro game. Either way, you can kind of get to feel out your opponent a bit more. Hate Me being a decent Zerg and whatnot, these guys have probably played each other on ladder, and they might already know each other's styles, but we would not be able to tell you that much. We're not looking over their shoulder when they play ladder, after all. And a Stargate's coming out for Strange, and Hate Me will have to suicide an Overlord if he hopes to scout this, because he's not getting Overlord speed. Is that a Zealot? Wait, he actually made a Zealot?
Wow. It's on the wall.
Wow.
Well, we have learned that, well, Zealots are terrible at holding the wall. Adepts can be worse, so.
That's true, yeah. The adept he made, of course, to go across the map. Got a scout, saw that there were lings already being made, I guess, and it's just like, there's hardly ever a chance for this adept to do damage, but occasionally you get that too quick of a transfer and you kill, like, 3 drones and whatever lings they pop out to. It's not going to be an Oracle opener, it's going to be Phoenix, so Hate Me wouldn't really have... I mean, if he had scouted this, he would have lost the Overlords anyway. if it was an Oracle opener, you know, maybe he loses drones, but now he knows it's a Stargate. He's gonna lose the Overlords. Nothing can be done about that. Could not have pulled them back, even if he scouted earlier. And that sucks a little bit. Luckily for Hate Me, there's no follow-up all-ins that really accompany this anymore. There used to be back in the day, but usually you see a Stargate with Phoenix. It's going to be a third base coming down. You see the Adept's already in a position to catch any Lings that tried to deny it. Hate Me doing a lot of scouting, seeing as Lings to, I guess, common areas where Adepts might get around your vision. And unfortunately, won't be able to do too much about the third base. Might not mind it either, since he has been given kind of the pass to go for full macro game too. Be totally prepared for it. Single illusion chamber. Not gonna do any drops unless there's overload speed, and even then it's a little bit dangerous against Phoenixes. That's probably just gonna be for plus one if he's a fan of the recent way to play, I suppose, with Zerg. He did get a Roach Worm, but that might just be for just in case. In fact, in a lot of cases, that seems to be what it's for.
Well, Phoenix is going to get a couple of drone kills. Nicely placed Spore Crawler and Queen, so make sure this doesn't stay too long. Overstain is welcome. Strange also going to get the back of this mineral line, but might be better off canceling the Adepts. He could certainly let them finish and try and kill drones, but there's only so many that he could kill. In fact, Lings and Queen's already on top, but that's not going to go well for Strange at all.
Yeah, I hate me not getting lazy with his micro, you know. Because if you don't pull the drones and there's only Queens, it takes forever to kill the Adepts, and they get like seven drones.
Yeah, they just target fire them down.
But that was well done by Hate Me. Strange didn't lose too much for it. Again, it's always like this fear that if you give away the Adepts, maybe they made 30 Lings and are now going to use them. But that's really not enough Lings to, you know, scare the third base. Sentry's getting a little too forward, but not such a big deal. It is going to be Banelings as well right off the bat. As I said, the Roach Warren could make a couple of Ravagers, could never use this at all. We just have to wait and see. Fourth base on the way. That should not be pressured too hard. Strange, you know, he didn't go for a fast Twilight Council or a fast Robo. He went for that Stargate, and that doesn't give you a lot of power to stop the macro. It gives you at most a couple of drone kills and scouting, which is always nice. He at least knows it's going to be Banelings, or at least he should. Oh, he hasn't gotten the main base yet. Oh, I didn't see the Evolution Chamber yet. How did he not see the Evolution Chamber? The one spot in Scotland Natural. Well, that kind of sucks. Okay, so Strange, so much for that scouting, is still a little in the dark. As I said, though, Zergs are, for the most part, going for Lings and Banelings. He hopefully just doesn't assume it's Roaches and get the... Not a wrong composition, but have his units in the wrong areas is what's kind of boiled down to lately. You can get Charge Immortal as long as you keep the Charge Lots back to clean out the Lings after. But here's the real thing you want to scout. A little bit dangerous to do this against a Stargate opener, but it is only one Stargate, and if it's a surprise, then to hell with you, it's a surprise. You can't get enough Phoenix in time.
Boo!
Yep. Oh, thank you for curing my hiccups. I'm so scared.
No problem. I live to serve.
Yeah. The Spire is not going to be scouted, but the way that Strange has been using his Phoenix, just on the edges, you know, gonna get the Queens, only a couple of drones here and there, chances are low, and he still doesn't have an accurate idea of what's happening. I think he thinks it's going to be mass Baneling, which he's not exactly wrong about, but now it's going to be more about that Spire. And if Hate Me realizes he hasn't been scouted too, that could be the real trick, you know? You think you're scouted, they have a Stargate, you only build 8 mutas, and you go in whatever else. You know you're not scouted, build as many as possible right off the bat, maybe even hide them a little bit longer, and then just instantly like run in with a bunch of Lings and mutas and snipe that Stargate. Get yourself a good lead, because of course Strange, he might have Stargates, he does not have Blink. If he loses that, there's really not much of an answer for the Mutas.
Well, Ling's find the Immortals, unfortunately. While I think there's a bit of hesitation to get on top of the sentries, he's not going to get a lot done with the Lings.
Mm-hmm.
I really like the Storm so quick, by the way. I think one of the biggest problems we're seeing consistently in this matchup is the Banelings. Obviously, that's not happening here, sure. But still, the potential is no longer an option to kill them. Instead, the Storms will work still well against what is a significant amount of Lings.
Yeah, I was going to say, the Storms can be kind of a double-edged sword. They're not going to help out very much against the Mutas, but Hate Me did not over-dedicate to Mutas, or dedicate as much as I wanted him to, so I can't even say over-dedicate. He is going for a lot more Banelings. This is where Storm's going to be absolutely perfect. Turn him into Archons after, and then the Mutas aren't going to be that much of a pain. It's only like 7 Mutas, so a warping of non-Blink Stalkers would be fine.
And if anyone can see it, Drogo gave us a prime example of like how good Storms versus Banelings look. Hate Me's just going to roll right through this. It's a little unfortunate. Lose all the Banelings for pretty much nothing. Takes out a single pylon for all his troubles. But the Corrosive Biles and the Ravagers still may be a little too much. It's only a couple of Immortals left over. But Hate Me's going to back away. Mutas also fly out of the main. And Strange has held this fight.
Yeah. I think he could have probably pulled back whatever Zealots he had in the front lines. And there's a chance that Immortal lives. But it was a small army to begin with for Strange. It was small but powerful. And it's still holding that kind of... that tagline, basically. Hate Me is going to be all about the numbers here, as he really is not going into more Mutas. He's not going into Infestation Pit. It's Ling Baneling. And if there's, if you run into more storms, it's eventually not going to work out that well. But storms aren't quite ready. Charge being warped in, but only after the Lings had a full surround. One storm was ready. But he needed that for the Banelings. He doesn't have enough High Templars. Where are those Archons that he formed? They die? I guess so. Immortals get crashed into while they soak up a ton of Banelings.
Yeah, but the Lings are all down, them. So the Ravagers just get on top, and they can focus everything down here pretty easily.
Very careful. Lings do not get the full surround on all the Immortals, so some of them do live. Those Phoenixes, I guess, kind of forgotten about. They were off patrolling the left side. Now come in to take care of the Ravagers, and things are still looking good for Strange, you know? Now he's warping in Stalkers, which seems a little weird because he does not have Blink. I think he's thinking more of, like, what can I warp in that won't just instantly die to the Banelings? Because Zealots will before they even get a charge off. But if he's going to get Stalkers, might as well get Blink. He's banking enough. He saved his fourth base. I'm a little surprised at that. It's not saturated, but it could be. And Hate Me is running out of, you know, opportunities to just brute force this game. Oh, there we go. Big old Muta swap. And that should be enough of a surprise. Go for the pylon powering the Stargate.
Yeah, actually, shut that down would be huge.
Oh, Hate Me. Gonna finally get that Nexus, Strange. Oh my god, no, he's not! I was gonna say Strange probably should have set up more SimCity. The Phoenixes came back and dealt with the initial Mutas, but there's still going to be 29 when everything is said and done. Oh dear. Oh dear.
And they are upgraded too. That's the other part of this, right? Like, plus two's on the way, should be done soon-ish. I think that this either leads into like base trade potential territory or Strange just gets walked over. I mean, his anti-air is questionable.
It really is. Still no Blink despite all these Stalkers. Muta's getting on top of the cannons. Not enough cannons. Not enough here. Phoenixes come in.
Even perfectly that, Phoenixes are dogfighting and not being microed at all.
Yeah, they weren't. No, they weren't.
It's because he is focusing. There's an attack on the south side of the map, and an attack on that northern right base actually goes down. So Zealots looking to get some kills on drones. Meanwhile, the main pushing force is still going forward. And that's a lot of storms. That's still 4 to 5 storms to this army.
Yeah. Where are those High Templars morphed in? He has cannons everywhere. Oh, he's going to rely on his fourth base. Kind of sucks that his fourth base is so low, though, to rely on. Those Mutas could just snipe it and leave. Just snipe it. Oh, he's gonna take care of the cannons either way. This army is not quite powerful enough to take on that many Mutas, by the way. Like, three Archons is almost enough, but once he turns the rest of the Tide Tempos into Archons, the Mutas definitely cannot take that on. It's certainly a base race. It's 28 Mutas.
It's something that might actually not go well for Hate Me, though, because the Mutas aren't going to kill buildings nearly as fast as Immortals will. And, oh, look at all these cannons coming. I love this choice out of Strange. Just cannon up that base and buy yourself as much time as possible.
There's an army forming, kind of, for Hate Me elsewhere. Unfortunately, lost the Roach War, and I think Ravagers would be better here. Oh, he actually gets all the High Templars. I just talked about how they need to morph into Archons. The Mutas could come back, probably KO this one pretty quick, and then just magic box the other two, and he could clean everything up and still have his main base and two mining bases, kind of, Macro Hatchery, to fall back on. I'd say go for it. There is one storm, maybe? Yeah, he runs right past it, magic box those Archons, exactly as I said. And he does clean this up. He loses a handful of Mutas. He went down, I think, from 29 to 21 with attacking that and whatever he was attacking in the natural. But Strange also has all of his bases set up. He has cannons, he has more Archons, he has more storms. But Hate Me has just a more army with the Mutas. Not if he clumps up his Archons, he doesn't. And mining. He sells 53 drones, too. So not bad for this long-distance mining. Banking a lot of gas. It's going to be very helpful. You put all 50 drones on mining minerals.
You know, I thought this was going to be, for both sides of the map, a lot more committed. And this is like where, right now, the game would be ending. You know, someone won or lose at this point. The fact that there is still mining... Actually, I really like this warping down here. As you say, and expansions only for Hate Me. It says, like, he's still going forward in the game. And, of course, Strange has locked down his base. So he's still going forward in the game. If that Zealot warping didn't come in, actually, I would say Hate Me would be in a very interesting spot. But shutting down that base is huge. Because 51 drones is too big for the two bases he's barely mining on.
We'll be able to clean this up, though. I mean, that war prism's only going to survive for so long. And when
should
that's
only
done,
survive for so long.
When that's taken care of, the Zealot run-by should really be limited. The Roach Runner's remade, so at the very least, maybe you can't take care of the Zealots before they get on your hatchery. The Roaches can be there to back it up.
Should've canceled that. Gets the kill again.
Yeah, should've canceled that.
Yo, base types are really expensive at this point. 300 minerals is a lot of money to have to replace. I mean, this... I didn't realize this base was long-distance mining, technically, either.
Yep. Ravagers will be very useful unless they run into the Archons and all die.
Oh, unless they move command into the Archons. Oh, no.
What? Those were going to be so important. Titan Templars are really slow.
He should have at least been aiming. I don't know. He's obviously focusing on the mutas elsewhere, so it's understandable his attention was spent, but man, oh, man. The muta count's actually not doing so hot. Still sitting at 18. It's not terrible, but how do you engage on top of all those cannons?
Well, you can probably engage on the cannons.
I don't know. Look how many there are. Come on.
No, I think you can snipe the pylons fast enough. There's no Archons to cover them.
Actually, yeah, there's only like two pylons if you
recognize
that.
No, I'm taking the cannons. The point is, though, is that like whether the cannons go down or not, enough mutas will die in the process that he can't replace those. And now Mothership Core helps with Photon Overcharge.
Yeah.
That's enough of a defense not to kill all the mutas, but to stop them from killing the base from overwhelming Strange. I really think the Ravagers are the worst thing lost in this game, though.
It's interesting that he didn't actually decide to make Archons for his home defense, either.
Yeah, that's always a little risky. With Archons, this would never, ever be broken. With Storms, it's still, like, eh, questionable. But, you know, he can't build more mutas. He lost those Ravagers that were going to maybe be able to take out the High Templars, but also help take out the cannons.
It was a very tight and very scary game one, I must say, and I'm much more thrilled for the series now than I was getting into it.
Yeah.
So all I saw, of course, was Grandmaster Symbol versus Master Symbol, and you kind of roll your eyes like, okay, I think I know how this is going to go.
Well, Strange is going to go for the literal base race at this point, you know, trying to get all the buildings, so he's cleaning up what he can. Actually, nope.
G-G.
Realizes it's not going to happen against those cannons. GG.
All right, so Strange takes that first game. Also, I'm now your waifu. Deal with it.
I don't want this waifu. Give me a new one.
But she's so cute. I love her hair.
No, I don't want it.
Okay. What? Pink lady. No?
Nah.
Okay.
I need the... Where's the tsundere?
Oh. There's this chick.
I like her. I'll take
her
as my waifu.
Yeah, whatever. I'd back her.
Yeah, exactly.
I didn't like you anyways.
We're gonna get into the lobby, but I need to be right back anyway, so we're gonna go to break. See ya. Long break screen. Alright, welcome back. Game number 2 on King Sejong Station. In the bottom right, as the Blue Zerg down one, he is Hate Me.
And then the upper left side, it's gonna be the red Protoss Strange. And I love that someone in chat comments like Rifkin showing more cleavage than Zombie Grove. And you know what? If it was my same personality, but I was a girl, I would probably definitely show more cleavage than Zombie Grove.
You 100% would have the same personality.
I 100% might have the same
personality.
What would change? What do you think? Okay, legit. I was a girl instead of a guy. What do you think would be different?
I think the factors that would have existed the 28, 27 years of your making would have been very different if you had been born a girl and recognized as a girl 27
years. Pretend it was like I grew up super tomboy or something. I don't know, didn't like a lot of other...
I mean, you're kind of asking me for a butterfly effect here, so...
Right? Well, you're the one who's saying my personality wouldn't be the same, whereas I would insist that it probably would be. I'd still probably be goofy and ridiculous and outspoken and dumb and all these other things that make up who I am. I don't think I would suddenly be like this very candid and reserved person who never swore or anything. Like, I don't feel like it would be so drastically
different.
I don't think you had to be.
I don't think you'd be drastically different, but I think.
What if it was way worse? Like, what if I was like actually super sexist as a woman?
It's possible.
Like, and I don't even mean like in like a conventional sense. I like straight up like male tears drinking a coffee cup to start a broadcast. Like,
you could. You also could not. You could have been the type to show more cleavage and been like totally open about that.
I think I'd be a hoochie mama.
There's
just
so many other different things I could attribute to it. Your favorite color would be different, maybe. You never know. It's a butterfly.
Yeah. What if I was colorblind? I don't know.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
All right, too many what-ifs for me. I'm not comfortable with this anymore. Okay. The Adept scouts the third before going in. I actually like that. Instead of just going straight to the mineral line, Strange could have gotten there a little bit faster, maybe got a drone kill or two extra for it, but knowledge of that third is a pretty big deal.
Sure, yeah, we've seen at least Bly do a two-base all-in. All in this map with Banelings. Another Stargate opener, strange.
That game, by the way, just to kind of comment on what could possibly happen with King Sejong, absolutely within the realm of possibility, Hate Me tries to force this into base trades again. I always love referencing back to our friend Penguin, right? He could beat players that were objectively way better than him because he was better at base trading than they were. And maybe that was Hate Me's mentality coming into that, or maybe it was just a forced situation. Either way, I want to point out, like, Strange actually played that game pretty much the way you'd expect. The only real part of that game where I went, what the fuck are you doing, bro, was the Phoenix's fighting the Mutas. The rest of it, the storms were nice, the double robo production was good, he was expanding like he needed to. So I feel like Strange, again, if this is going to be like a more conventional game, I'm feeling better for him. But I'm not saying Hate Me couldn't overtake him in something like a planned base trade or something extreme.
Sure. 200 subs is resub for 7 months. I could have sworn I shouted you out like a week ago.
Was it? We had more than 200 subs 7 months ago.
That's true, we did.
Maybe that was like, was it 7 months ago we got the 200 subs in one day?
Wait, is this a serious question?
I don't know, I'm asking.
Yes, it is the day that we got over 100.
Oh, okay. Subs. I thought this guy was celebrating us getting 200 subs on the channel. I'm like, man, we did that a long time ago.
Huh.
7 months? Really?
Yeah, it was 7 months. We've definitely had this conversation before, and like I said, I thought it was like a week ago that I shouted him out, and it was like, yeah, that must have been the Alima League 7 months ago. It was early in the year, I guess.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy. It's also sad because that's definitely when we peaked and we'll never get that action ever again.
Just like high school. No,
you peaked
I was
in high school?
No, it was the opposite.
I don't
opposite
think you peaked
of
in high school.
It was
yeah,
the
I think
opposite.
You peaked on like Bay Street TV, bro.
Or
haven't peaked yet is what I meant to say.
I mean, I don't last year might have been a peak. Who knows?
Hey, well,
only
I
time
like
will tell.
I like to peek into the girls shower. Cause I'm a perv. That joke didn't work out the way I wanted it to.
I think the silence is really helping it too.
Yeah, well, I'm used to that. That's not. That's not
I'm
you.
There for you.
All right. Yeah. say nothing if you agree. The adepts do transfer in. Gonna chase those drones around. Not a sweet Ling defense like before, but still, the adepts are going to eventually go down to these queens.
Seven drones this time.
Yeah, and he actually gets them out alive. Yeah. That's actually a huge difference.
Wow, getting all of them out. Well, the Stargates, how many things did it make? Just four, actually, not even going up to the typical five. Chrono Booster probably put something else. There you go. And Twilight Council is on the way. Hate Me is going for what seems to be the exact same build here. You got the Roach Swarm, he's not going to use it. The plus one's on the way. Question is how much he's going to dedicate to the Spire, if at all, you know? For at least two attacks, it was about the Banelings. He tried to make that work, tried to kind of force the issue, and then realized it wasn't working. Banked enough for Mutas and tried that too, but that didn't work either in that last game. So what's his plan here? Because so far it really is about, I think, more what is Hate Me going to do, because Strange is just going to defend in macro.
So I tried to ask the chat, if I was weapon, would I be a vampire or a Frankenstein? And I kind of forgot vampire was censored. So the question did not work out properly. And I'm sure people are filling in that blank with a lot of different words that are not vampire.
Yeah. So you want to be like Frankenstein's daughter or like a vampire girl?
Well, I was just thinking of that stupid movie Frankenstein Girl versus whatever that...
That's exactly what I was doing. Frankenstein's daughter versus vampire girl.
Was it a daughter? I didn't realize it was daughter.
Yeah, I remember because the dad was the evil scientist that put everything together and put her
together. If we're going to real talk, no, I don't remember.
Like, and Frankenstein is the guy that put the monster together. He's not the monster. Okay, whatever.
I tried to put everything for that moment of watching crap out of my mind forever.
It is a great movie if you just want to show something stupid to your friends.
No.
Yeah. Yeah, that and Wolf Cop or whatever.
Disagree.
Where his dick explodes.
The thing you guys don't understand is she's being literal, so I can't.
Yeah, it really does. In this movie, you don't just transform into a wolf all, like, you know, calm and collected. You literally explode out of your human suit.
Words can't describe how beautiful you would be, but numbers can. 4 out of 10. Wow! Feels bad, man. But
that is amazing. That is so good.
It's better than a 3. Look on the bright side.
Oh, we have a complete change up in Hate Me's composition here. It's actually going to be Lurkers. Fairly quick. but with the upgraded lings still, so those are really going to provide the fodder. Handful of Ravagers were made, but not even a bother to upgrade the Roaches, because he really just wants the Ravagers. We are the reason StarCraft is dead.
Well, I mean, look at the shit we're talking about right now.
Until I said the penis exploding comment, I didn't think it was that bad.
Why'd you say it again?
Does Strange know it's gonna be Lurkers? He does not. Unless he saw the army composition, he didn't see the Lurker den at the very least. Army is like right there. He should have scouted this. Lurkers quite yet, just a lot of Hydras.
It's still a lot of brute force, but here come those Templar, and they've got a lot of storms ready to go. And this is a very choked up, very clumped up army. And frankly, Strange could be in trouble if he stays. Ooh. In fact, he might be overstaying. Yeah, backs away is a good idea.
Yeah. Little bit of an attack off to here, but it's not going to be able to get a cancel on that Nexus. I like that the rocks are broken down as well to provide that extra layer of safety. And now Hate Me has to wait for his Lurkers if he wants a better army fight next time. And I just say, you know, that's going to give Strange a little bit of time to recover, to get his army back into position. He's now covering this side of the map as opposed to barely covering it. Yeah, I'm getting to it. He has to wait for his Lurkers. I don't think he'd ever really dedicate.
Yeah, I think that there shouldn't be any extreme poking without
the... I'm a hot skill, I'm a 10, baby. Thanks.
Perfectly timed for the previous conversation, I guess. But I was just going to say, like, I don't think he should. Everything should be focused around those Lurkers more than anything else. Now, does this mean Rifkin would make a better girl than Zombie Grub, or just I would be better as a girl? Is that the message here? Just as Rifkin would make a better girl.
I don't know. Fleet Beacon's already on the way. Two more Stargates. Maybe start off with one, so it's a little excessive, but whatever. Hate Me, he's advanced to Lurkers, but finding Strange Army out of position. This might be the best part about it, or maybe the worst part. Lurkers are now defenses on the backside, and Immortals coming in here. But remember that Strange's army is mostly about the storms, so it's not like he has so many Immortals. He's powering through this, and more Lurkers on the backside. Get on top of those High Templars. Oh god, no. That's like Strange. The Strange's army is so small, but it was powerful in a correct position. The blink of an eye, it all just disappears. His fourth goes away, and Hate Me is one. He's just one.
Yeah. I really thought after that first engagement, like, it looked like Strange was so ready. He did such a good job, you know, getting these cells out for counterattacks. He's still warping in for counterattacks. This might become a bit base racy as his only option, but this is not an army that he can stop. And I mean, it's not even about the Ravagers or the Lings, it's the Lurkers. How do you deal with any of those Lurkers?
It's about everything right now. I know Strange has 40 army supply, but I don't know how. It's in these zealots in a war prison. He's gonna get to Hive. That's pretty amazing. Cancel at the last second? Why bother? Whatever.
So I would like to address the accusations that you're the only one trying to cast here.
Yeah.
And just bring it back to that picture from yesterday where it's like, here you are talking about the exploding penis, but I'm the one ruining everything.
Okay, well, I think the difference, to their credit, is that you don't go, well, we do have something going on here in the game. You just continue on with it. Like, you'll roll with the penis exploding, and you'll roll with anything else.
I'm just a great conversationalist, what can I say?
I agree, I actually agree with that. I think they're too harsh on you.
But I'm just saying, it kind of goes back to that picture from yesterday. Okay, I will say this for Strange. He's doing a pretty good job hanging in there. Four Immortals are actually a number that can take on Lurkers, but I don't think he's ever going to get to a point where the Ling Floods will be manageable.
He's trying, man. He's trying to get Archons and Zealots, and if they could all just come together, then maybe he does hold. But he's down
come
a base.
Together.
Hate Me lost Line a base, but up. It was a base that was already mostly mined out. He's still mining off of it. It was his Hive. Yeah. All right, that's a big deal. But I think that Hate Me still has the better economy off the back of this, better army replacement.
So I will go back on something I said earlier. I said I don't think Strange will ever deal with the Lurkers, and I'm actually really impressed. Not in the Immortal count. Like, that was good that he got that built up, but he was using his Phoenixes really well, mostly on Ravagers more than Lurkers, of course, but just being able to surgically, I guess, recover from that situation. But as you pointed out, the money on the other side of the map is going to be the continued brute force. When they were on equal economy and Strange had a fourth base, Hate Me was able to overcome him. Now he's got a massive advantage and Strange has no fourth base. I think this should still be Hate Me's game.
Yeah.
Strange's that's gonna... a lot of lurks that just got remade.
Strange is going to try and play the macro game out still, but soon enough he'll need a fifth as well as a fourth. He's on a very good number of probes for even mining if he had enough mineral patches, but he's running out soon. Phoenix is going to be extra active now that they have some job to do, make up for this game basically, but they only have so much energy, so three drones go down and that's it. Looking for probably more of a collapsing situation, he could just go from both sides, and I don't think there'd be enough storms to cover both. Storms will instantly, or almost instantly, KO a lot of these units, Hydras and Lings after all, but... Oh, it doesn't set up! There we go, on that ramp, there it is.
Well, the Lurk account actually reminds me a little bit of watching Guru. There's not a lot of like finesse with it, it is just like all here. He's trying to bait him to perhaps come out to take a fight, but the Lurkers are not really able to push in, and these can't eat storms much longer.
Well, there's no more storms, it's who is baiting. Job well done, I'd say. More trying to come from the back, but they're still a couple of seconds away from storm. Lurkers move forward, and a lot of them die. Like, a ton of them are dying here. They're trying to take away Archons, wow. And is barely not able to kill them.
But this is the problem. They're clumped up without cover. Like, the Hydra should have been on top of the Lurkers, not off to the side on their own.
Yeah,
and because of that, they were able to just easily move in on top of it. I mean, make no mistake, guys. Lurkers are great. They've got range, they've got damage, but Immortals can take the hits, and they can deal more damage.
Oh my god, if Strange can get Dark Templars, keeping Hate Me back off this fourth base, he could get a fourth. He might be able to get a fifth. Like, Dark Templars could be a serious way back in this game. Hate Me is just really, clearly, mostly relying on his income and his greater army advantage, because his engagements, as smart as he's trying to make them, are just not end up going very well at all. And it's a great thing that he has this drone count, but he knows there aren't spore crawlers. He knows that the army is always on the offensive, not defending bases. And Dark Templars could ruin Hate Me's game.
Well, maybe. If he actually gets Broodlords out, I will say, well, there's an answer to the Lurkers, there's certainly not going to be one to the Broodlords.
That's a good point. You can't afford very many of them, but one at a time, eventually get up to like six or seven, and Strange really can't afford to go for, his... he almost went towards Tempests. He was so close to it, but oh well.
This is so cool, though. I like this, because, we got some people in chat asking who's winning. They don't really know what's going on. It is a little bit back and forth.
Oh,
it's
dear.
Always been the Zerg who's winning,
those
but it's more like Strange refuses to die.
Yeah. Those storms are right in between the Lings and the Hydras. They're kind of useless. They're like 1 out of 10 storms.
By the way, context here being, of course, if you're just joining us recently, it is 1-0 for Strange. It's still the preliminaries of the group. So if Hate Me wins this, we'll go to a game 3. If Strange manages to actually pull this back, and I'm going to be honest, I don't think that's going to happen, but it's going to be super sick if he does, then that'll be the 2-0 and we'll go straight to the winner's match.
What took these guys so long to start attacking? There we go. So now the question is, does the army of Hate Me pull back? Or, there you go, just do something. He knows it's there. Or does he continue the attack and just try and end the game? I think he can end the game with the Broodlords. Like, Strange really can't afford, gas-wise now, to go for any amount of Tempests. The Phoenix are going to get instantly KO'd by the Hydralisk. And this should just be game.
Yeah. The Broodlords, again, were going to be just a little bit too much. GG. It will take game number 2. Tying it up now 1-1.
That took quite a time, though. So we're going to go to an ad
Wait,
break.
Before we go, say something really nice. Compliment me on how I look.
You look great.
Back.
You did this before. Alright. Hello again. Hello.
What was that voice? Why are you going all like, what is a lesbian horse?
I'm done. Oh my god.
Yeah, we're slowly losing our sanity as we get deeper into this, guys. Mostly because we're getting a little 2-minute breaks here, but nothing big or substantial enough for us to go get food. So we're both pretty hungry right now. And I'm sure most of you know that dizzy feeling that kicks in. I don't know about you, Zombie Grub. I'm kind of getting that.
A dizzy feeling? Ho ho!
You're a big mini.
Yeah.
Can we do? I know you don't normally do this with me, but can we introduce the next players as Mickey Mouse?
No, because I'm so bad at it.
In the top left, it's gonna be Strange.
I avoid things I'm bad at. Oh, I'm trying to read this damn news article. Damn it. Is entering into a 2-year agreement with ESL to bring esports to mainstream audiences via distribution across Yahoo's properties.
Who?
ESL and Yahoo.
Oh, Yahoo. Sorry, I didn't hear that Yahoo part.
No one cares about Yahoo. I mean, yay! Esports is growing. Oh, it's set up 1-1. In top right, I'm Frost.
No, do the Mickey Mouse, come on!
He's in the red turn range!
Do it again as Mickey Mouse!
No, I won't. No.
Oh,
no.
Okay, well, in the bottom right. It's gonna be the Berserk. Hate me!
You sound, you know, like you're not exactly wrong with the Mickey Mouse voice, but it sounds like a serial killer. Mickey Mouse.
He's got like the Jason mask on.
I don't know how they put the innocence into it normally. That must be put in sound mixing. Needs to be a little more innocent and a little less serial killery.
Right now. I hope you don't find his corpse under your bed.
Jesus Christ.
You can't do it anyway. Just stop. You're ruining it. You killed Mickey Mouse for me. Oh my gosh.
Oh, well, he killed a lot of people first. So.
Apparently, M.I.C. How about you, M.I.C.?
Oh, I really, like, yesterday was surprisingly okay. I remember, like, at hour 6.5, you were like, you know, we don't feel that bad. I think it's the combination 2 days in a row. I hope to God tomorrow is not as long.
It's just the playoffs, so... 4 best of 3s, 2 semifinals, and a partridge and a pear tree.
All right, how many max keeps?
5!
12, 22,
rings,
29 max games. 5 3 best of 3s is 15 games.
2 semifinals. No,
10, 30. So that could be the same amount of time, though. Those are around the same amount of games if everything is played out.
Yeah, well, they also might be 2-0s. I don't know. We'll see who gets through. Because we got to be honest, some of these groups are... It's all Protoss and Zerg. It's not like there's literally not going to be Terran, guys. Don't get your hopes. I love Beastie. No, I'm just kidding. If Beastie gets through the group, we'll have a Terran. But for the most part, every match is going to be PvP. There's the ZBZ and then PvZs. So unless Beastie gets in there to throw a wrench into the works, and don't get me wrong, I really want Beastie to get through because goddamn, I don't want to cast a full day of no Terran. Their matches are going to be kind of predictable, so I don't know. We'll see. But all right, so speaking of seeing, Strange going to get to the bottom right and go for that scout. Look at that. He's losing the third base and rides away as if he was on a Segway as sick as mine.
Thank you to Kitty the Neko for the 20-month resub. Praise be to Ace Cat.
Ace Kate.
Oh, dear. I'm so done. I can't even think right now.
Rifkin, please take less pain medication. Man, I never got any pain medication. The sad reality is you're dealing with normal Rifkin here. Like, this is just hungry, sober Rifkin, sadly.
This is... Casting is getting too tiring.
Yeah, we've actually been troopers, man. We've been going all week for this stuff, too. Waking up super early, doing some triple days.
Double days. Oh, my God.
Yeah, feels good though. Lots of
triple,
good work.
Double, long ass casts.
It feels nice looking at the ad revenue numbers for once in ever. So I can do with
we'll
it.
We'll be $5 instead of $1.
We'll be 100 airs by the end of the month if we're lucky.
All right, well.
What do you think of the Dark Shrine?
Yeah, Dark Shrine. I think this is a powerful attack. First, you hit
the one post on Reddit where the guy had a bunch of pictures of Dark made into a shrine.
To be honest, I don't watch enough of Dark a game to even realize why he's so good. I just hear people talk about him.
But did you actually see the Dark Shrine?
I did, yes. I saw the actual picture, but I just don't know why.
That was like Hey Arnold with that Helga girl who had like the closet with all his pictures and candles in it. That's what I thought of right away.
Ugh, yeah, that was... So first you can hit with the Adepts. They won't have Resonating Glaives here, although you can fit that in some other versions of this build. But then you attack with the Dark Templar after, and it's like a 1-2 punch. Bam, 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 bam. It's only 4 gateways. It's not even that much of a bam. It's like a punch bam. But 4 DTs right off the bat into that warp prism. Third Nexus looks like it's going to be put down on the follow-up. Hate me, do you have any spore crawlers? Yes, he does. In fact, he has more than one spore crawler per base. That's not necessary. Now, he's really afraid of, I guess, all 4 DTs sacking themselves on a spore crawler. Maybe he's played Strange before. Huh. Soundtrack's over.
Oh, I didn't. What?
Sometimes you realize the music's very dramatic in the background.
It is. The Archon drops are certainly funny to see, but working out somewhat effectively. And what'll be nice is if you can keep that warp prism alive, and you should, there's a safety guarantee out of there. The biggest detriment to an Archon, you know, it doesn't have blink, it's not fast. Getting away from situations is not what it's really intended to do. But it does bring a lot of damage, and thanks to that warp prism, they both get out of there alive. 6 kills on one, 7 on the other.
Yeah, not bad. What? No, Nikutum, we're banning this. Damn production tab. Alright, so Strange DT opener did not work, really. The Archon did a decent job trying to make up for that. But overall, not too useful. Hate Me just recently got 65 drones, almost 70 I guess now, and he doesn't have a fourth base quite yet, so I guess he's not too perfect either. And I am a little worried about the Spire, you know, like he's getting roaches right now, that's taken away from what could have been like this awesome huge bank. And the Spire might just be a useless structure for 200-200, especially if Strange is gonna follow this like a blink attack here. It's gonna be without upgrades, but it's gonna be off the back of quite a few gateways, 9? 8. 8 gateways. Could just be a poke, could be nothing. Could just be what his competition's gonna look like. But Hate Me needs to decide right now, like, is this gonna be roaches? I guess the Spire is, it's really not gonna be used yet.
My mind is fucking blown right now.
Why?
People apparently pronounce Ace Kate as Ace Cat E, like Wally.
Ace Cat A.
The logic when it was made a long time ago was like, if dog became Doge, cat could become Kate. So, I like the idea of Cat E. Like, you're being real cat-y right now, you know that?
Oh, I thought it was just a pair up with the other emoticon that is no longer.
What other emoticon?
The emote that should not be named. Anyway.
Voldemort.
So, I think Hate Me realized the attack was on the way. Yeah, he's all
oh,
the...
Oh, but look at that. Look at that concave he gets on top of this. The roaches end up pushing into a bit of an odd engagement path. Blinking
do,
back
but...
on the Stalkers, keeping a lot of them alive. But the Lings being the secret heroes as they reinforce in, the Stalkers have to shoot through them before they can get on top of those low-health Ravagers.
Yeah. Hate Me does push this back, and it's really good. Like, again, like the Spire feels a little bit useless. That could have been 200-200. In, you know, more units, although I guess he's having a lava problem right now. But it's good that he didn't try and go for a Spire, because if Shady had, like, 8 mutas instead of anything else, Blink Stalkers would have taken them all out. He realized what was happening, he responded correctly to it, and once again, Hate Me is in a good position. He's still on a fourth base, though. Like, I really think, yeah, definitely throw on a fourth base. Start those mutas now, that you're able to push them entirely back, and while Strange isn't on a bad economy, his tech is not very good at all. You know, he's got Blink Stalkers and Dark Templars, and that's it. Okay, that's funny. Whoopsie. Whoops-a-daisy, but... Hate Me is doing a good job. I'm just a little fearful that he might get caught over-defending, and Strange might find an avenue back into this game. But if he's just going to continue committing to a Blink Stalker attack, then that might not be a problem. Hate Me does take a fourth base off the bottom left. I like that. He needs to send drones eventually, you know? He's going to be oversaturated in his main and natural. But Strange not even going for fourth base. He goes up a ramp that's never going to work out. Muta numbers were not very high, but they are going to provide a little bit of counterattack potential. Oh, I didn't... That's not on purpose.
Stalkers were stuck on the Adept, so that accidentally leaves them behind to defend.
Yeah, exactly. Probe's going to go down. It's going to split Strange's attention, and Hate Me is just trying to get as much of an army as possible on the defense. And while his macro, you know, it's not enough larva for it right now, he's getting units. He's getting a defense army, and I don't think Strange's pure Blink Stalker army is going to work.
No, if this was Heart of the Swarm, and he had upgrades with this, I could make a good case on this working. But it's not Heart of the Swarm anymore.
Oh,
there's
dear.
No upgrades going into it. They are getting absolutely demolished by the Lynx. Forget the Ravagers for a second. That surround was brutal. He's going to have another one here in just a second. Soccer's still on cooldown, blinking away, trying their best to escape, but that's everything going down for Strange, and he doesn't have the money to replace this with Warpins. And I think Hate Me just sent himself to the winner's match.
Yeah, he will go on to face a Laser and a ZVZ, whereas Strange will go on to face PC Cutie in a PVT.
That's actually going to be a really interesting one. I want to see Beastie, but of course they'll be... Actually, we don't know. Are they doing this them at the same time?
They said they are not.
They are not. Fuck!
Maybe they've changed their mind, realizing that this still went on for quite a time, but I don't know.
Okay, well, I just want to say, if they are going to do it at the same time, I want to watch Beastie's match. If they aren't, then yeah, we'll just do them one after the other.
Yeah.
Overcharge goes off. He does not going to die a little too quick. Still warping in Stalkers, but as we've seen up to this point, Stalkers are not the answer. And while Adepts may have been a better choice for Lings, they're not the better choice for Banelings. And as the Stalkers blink away, they'll just open the doorway for those Adepts. He ends up spending a lot of the Banelings on the Nexus. I'm not sure if that was a mistake or a misclick or what that was. That was actually a huge problem for Payne, but he still just got so much army supply, so much raw power, brute force numbers coming in. 9,600 army supply. GG! Hate Me takes the series 2-1.
A round of applause.
I can't clap my hands because I'm animated. I can sway my chest back and forth, though. Look at this.
So can I. It's not even... Oh, it's not even that dramatic. Okay, well...
I think you swinging your chest back and forth is probably going to look better than my anime character. This is the argument for 3D waifus, guys. I don't know if you're doing it. You're probably not doing it, but yeah. Look at this. It's so lame. It's not even good.
Back and forth in my chair.
Like, you're like, I'm cracking my back. I don't know about my chest.
I should... casting both, right? Okay, we're gonna get this all types of set up and ready to go and stuff, and we're gonna take a break, so see you guys soon.
Bye!